What's going on, people? I am Kevin Hart, a.k.a. Mr. Comedic Rockstar. Cold as balls is on the way. The tub is colder, and my balls are bigger, too. Look, I got two big balls.
What's up, bro?
Hey, T.O. Welcome to the show. It's cold as balls, and our guest today is Tia.
Well, what's with the attitude?
I got a little bone to pick with you, buddy. How about you take your robe off, let's get in the tub, and we can talk about it.
That's a bit of
I crazy. Would sing a song called Fly, Eagles Fly with you, but I can't.
Oh, so that's why you're mad.
So we got a lot to talk about. We had good years in Philadelphia. What's going on here?
What? These are tights.
Where your trunks at?
Trunks?
You don't put on trunks?
No, it's the same thing.
Where the f*** is your body fat at?
You got it. Look like it.
I ate before this episode. So
I did too.
Oh, ain't this a Just get in the tub. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to an all new episode of Cold as Balls. I'm your host, Kevin Hart. And my guest today is T.O., a.k.a. Terrell.
Thank
Owens.
You.
Everybody calls you Terrell. Does that piss you off?
Thank you for the correct pronunciation.
But you spell it like Terrell.
No. Terrell would be with an E at the end.
I didn't do the spelling.
I'm just correcting you.
Ask me how to say your name.
How do you say my name?
Terrell.
That's correct.
I'm going to celebrate. Why here? Let me celebrate.
Are you?
Ooh.
Of course. Okay. You ready? Okay.
Touchdown. Sorry, YN, take that back. Talk to me about the celebration dance. I think you're responsible for the antics. Give me your best one.
Probably the impromptu ones. San Francisco, I got the guy, he dragged him in the end zone. And then I didn't really know what I was gonna do at the time, so I just went and grabbed the cheerleaders, pom-poms, and...
And you start doing the...
Yeah, I'm getting in.
I was just gonna tell you we can get in, but... I mean, you didn't have to get in just yet. We had time. All right, let's get back to the celebration dances real quick. What's the one dance that you actually regret doing?
There's not any that I regret.
Never. You never felt like you should take it back?
No.
I've done some.
Such as?
Darryl, you remember I told you I played quarterback. I was told that I had what you would call a rocket for an arm. So I scored a touchdown and took a rocket out the back of my football tights, and I lit that bitch on fire. And it hit a guy named Charles in the eye. Took his eye out. But the whole thing behind the celebration was to light the rocket on fire, it take off, and then I put up my arm, and people go, oh, he's doing a rocket. But when Charles started crying, ain't nobody do that. So I say all that to say that I'm sorry, Charles. So have you ever thought of something that you want to do and then you didn't do it?
I did the celebrations that I wanted to do.
Spiking the ball on the star.
That was
the Dallas
creative.
Cowboys.
That was creative.
At that moment, did you feel like, oh, shit, I went too far?
No.
Who was it that came and chased you?
George T.
George T.
But it didn't even faze me. I see all the comments and stuff. Like, oh, he got clocked or whatever. I'm like, bro, he just grazed over the top of me.
That hit.
Right. That's probably the biggest hit he'd had the whole game.
Oh, my God. The trash talking still goes on until this day. So this is your opportunity. Do you tell him right now that...
George, it didn't hurt.
It didn't
like
hurt.
It was real weak. Just like your game, it was real weak.
He just called you a...
I mean, it was weak.
It was weak. Well, I'm glad we got it out here on Cold as Balls. Exclusive. Exclusive. Hey, throw me the ball. I got celebration. Throw me the ball. Hands, like T.O.
Oh, you just come prepared. What are you writing?
My signature says, to whom it may concern, this ball was caught on this date, and on this date, history was made. P.S. You b-. That's what I'm talking about.
Dog, you gotta get in, dog.
Where are you at? I clearly threw you the ball for you to catch it. I'm gonna get in the water. I'm sorry about that, T.O. I know you're disappointed in our race. Were you ever shut down?
No.
How was Jerry Rice when it came to dealing with your rise as a star?
Jerry was one of those guys, he led by example. Mm-hmm. And so again, I think we had similar pass as far as going to small division schools. Mm-hmm. He went to Mississippi Valley State.
M-I-S-S-I, humpback, crooked letter.
Yeah, that. And I went to UT Chattanooga.
What?
UT Chattanooga.
The f*** is that?
University of Tennessee at Chattanooga.
Did y'all have uniforms?
That's disrespectful, Kev.
I swear, I don't know why I keep you around. Biggest misconception about you?
I think a lot of people think that, really, I'm an asshole, to mm-hmm. be honest. But that's really not who I am.
So who are you? If you wanted to take the opportunity right now to look in the camera and educate people on who you are.
Well, number one, I'm a God-fearing man, number one. My grandmother raised me. Mm-hmm. I've never been in any trouble. I've been able to represent not only the organizations that I played for on the field, mm-hmm. and I've represented them the same off the field. My intentions were pure. If somebody asked me a question about the nature of the game or something that happened in the game, I answered the question honestly, mm-hmm. not understanding that they could spin and misconstrue.
Manipulate. They can take your words and they can manipulate. It's
getting kind of warm. I'm gonna get on down in here.
You know what? All right, we're gonna go ahead and get on. Take his white hand. If we're gonna get down, let's get down. All right. You want some? Go ahead. Yeah, thanks, white hand.
Yeah.
That's right on time right now, because it's getting pretty juicy.
You want some?
Yeah, let me give a little bit of popcorn.
Come on.
No, that's, I don't have long arms. T, I'm gonna need you to extend a little bit. T, I'm gonna need you to extend a little bit. T, if I can get you to extend a little bit. You're a thick ass, the one for yourself, huh? Let's talk Hall of Fame. How do you feel about you not being put in the Hall of Fame when it first came around?
Ridiculous. It's a travesty.
Yeah.
Hall of Famers spoke out about it. Obviously, a lot of the fans that have watched me play.
Why the delay, though?
That C word earlier, which character, a lot of the voters kind of added to the mix of really kind of the criteria of inducting guys. It should be about your body of work and your accomplishments.
And nothing else.
But when it came to me,
everything else came into play.
Right.
Which is bullshit. When I was hand modeling, right? I was hand modeling.
What?
Hand modeling. And
for
who? Well, name it. Heinz ketchup, Red Rooster hot sauce. I can go down. But there was a moment where, you know, we select a certain amount of hands that go into what we call the Hand Hall of Fame. Watch this. If this is a bottle of ketchup right here, right? The trick is you cover up the label first, and then there's a reveal. Heinz ketchup. See that right there? My hands make it amazing. These are Hall of Fame.
So if that's the case, these could be, except for this finger.
Well, I'm not gonna lie to you, man. These hands look exactly like deer hoofs. You ever see a deer, when a deer do this? That's what your hands look like. Bam, bam, knock his popcorn off, please. He's fast, he's still got good hands. Why'd you decide to speak in Chattanooga?
Oh, pardon me.
What? Why are you smacking like that?
I love popcorn.
What in the Chattanooga?
I'm always, get your popcorn ready at all times.
What was the reason for speaking in Chattanooga and not the Hall of Fame?
That was really where I started to really kind of find myself as an athlete.
Okay.
It wasn't a selfish moment, although I understood the backlash that I was gonna take. And what a lot of people don't know is that I spoke to the president prior to everything. Yeah. It is about the future. It's really for me to really use my voice and my platform to try to bring about change, but in a good way. I didn't have any aspiration to play beyond the collegiate level.
So you didn't go there with plans on being an NFL wide receiver?
There were so many guys that were better than me in high school, mm-hmm. and then when I got to college, I still realized that I was behind.
I mean, I can't relate to that because I was always in front. Because of my skill set.
No, I think you were always in front because you were short, Kevin, and everybody was taller than you.
Or because I was the best. If you Googled clips from me and my church football league, you'll see me destroying other Christians on the football field. If it helps any, I voted for you. So I don't know. I definitely don't think Bam Bam did, but I know I did.
Do I get to ask any questions?
Yeah, go ahead. You can ask me some stuff.
What's my middle name?
Bernard. Bernard.
No.
Owens.
Yeah, can we get a line?
What you talking? You don't even know his name. I thought they called you TBO.
No, just T-O, but no, no.
No, I could have swore it was T-B-O.
Oh, jokes. Okay, my middle name is El Dorado.
What?
El Dorado. I like it. I've learned to embrace it because if you know about anything about an El Dorado, it's like one of those cars, you know what I mean? Nice interior, Cadillac.
It's a piece of
come on.
That's what it is. El Dorado, what?
Kev, come on.
That don't go with nothing in your name.
Kev, look into the camera and apologize to my mom. Her name is Marilyn.
Miss Marilyn. Now listen, I bet you are a beautiful, loving woman. Okay, but I know when somebody's drunk.
Whoa, Kevin.
Yeah.
What's your middle name?
Darnell. Kevin Darnell Hart.
Darnell?
It sounded like Danielle. She parallel parked that middle name in between your first and last name. This is why they didn't want you in the Hall of Fame. It was the middle name. Listen up, El Dorado. After hearing this, I don't think there's any more that we can talk about. Bam Bam, you gotta give me more ice for a bad middle name. My middle name. God damn! Damn it! God!
I like this bucket of ice. Oh, just sign the bucket.
Sign it, El Dorado.
No, I'm assigned to Kevin Danielle Hart.
It's Darnell.
No, it's Danielle.
No, Bam Bam. You're gonna. Bam Bam. Okay, this show is going to your head. Down. Put the bucket down. Put the bucket down. No.
Oh, he getting jiggy with it. Okay.
And score
Bam Bam, I'm getting legit. I like that. Like all that. Right. Hey, I like that move, though.
We're gonna wrap this amazing episode of Cold as Balls up with a Hall of Fame speech from me, but not me as Terrell El Dorado Owens.
Okay, preach.
Once, I was mistaken. Twice, it was taken.
Okay, I like this.
But on the third time, there will be no more mistaken. I am football. I am deer hoof hands. I have a middle name that does not go with anything that I stand for. But what I do is catch. And where you can catch me is in the Hall of Fame. Because I am now where I should have been a long, long time ago.
Can we get out? Can we get out now?
Hold on, let me just finish my speech. Oh, would you say Dallas Cowboys? Huh? Didn't want me in the Hall of Fame. Remember this?
What's that?
That's what you did. It's been another episode of Cold as Balls. And if you got an El Dorado, I want you to take that outside and throw it in the trash. That car sucks, man. From one Hall of Famer to another, I got to get you to come down to my church. Wait, hit me in the end zone. Bow!
That's the wrong sport.
Don't grab me when I'm on my route, man. You grab me when I'm on my route. That's pass interference.